Hello, we're here in match number one versus Medvedev. I'm gonna go ahead and look up what they are usually playing. I recognize this player. I am on the draw. This is generally a slow hand. Let's see. Medvedev. Looks like they are an elves player. Let's see. Stompy? They're a Stompy player? I don't know. Possibly Stompy. This is not, I think, fast enough versus anything, so a mulligan. This seems fine. Probably just cut the second chancery. Would like to draw a draw spell, but this sets me up against aggro. Or Faye. I suppose I can bin. I'll get rid of the Archaeomancer and then basically any draws live. And I have insurance against aggro. This player was on Stompy in a recent challenge and top 8'd. Okay, so it's most likely they are on Stompy. Kind of have to be concerned about things like Savage Swipe. So if I can, I'm going to play around it. There's Nest Invader, it's 100% Stompy. So I'm just going to play the Chancery and pass. We're down a bit. I think here I'm going to grab the planes. That way I can play out the Faithful plus Preordain and have Ephemerate. We're going to go to 14. They possibly are holding up things like Vines and Savage Swipe. Oh, no, they're just going to hunger their guy, hunger their creature. Now, if they tap out, that is getting bounced. All right, that's really good for me. So I get to go Faithful, snap this. Untap, untap. And then I guess ponder. Prohibit familiar. I think I'll just play out the familiar. And then I can risk blocking with the familiar. Next turn, I can go Familiar plus Preordain and Chancery. Or Echoing Truth some of their creatures. So we know one card in their hand is the Nettle Sentinel. Two unknowns. Likely one of them is a Savage Swipe. So if they're going for Swipe, they'll probably try to kill the Faithful. It would be a bit of a blowout if they, attacked, swiped, and then also vines. But I guess then I can play the familiar and echoing truth something, and then be set up to hopefully draw into a creature. They're gonna swipe the familiar. All right, based on that, I'm not gonna block. Just Echoing Truth, the Nest Invader. I just think I want to preordain into the familiar. Okay, that's good. So I can play the Mold Drifter out no matter what now. And I can do Drifter Ephemerate. So they just have to play around the cards in their hand. So now they're attacking for six. So I just have to block both creatures. Block, block. They'd have to have hunger plus vines to kill me. And they don't have anything. Woohoo! Just have Nest Invader, so I can Echoing Truth the Nest Invader. I think step one is Drifter Ephemerate and see where we go from there. Because if I can draw an island, then I probably can't lose here. Still, I'm planning on Echoing Truth the Nest Invaders if I can. Right. Okay, so I didn't draw into a blue source to hold up, but I can fetch a blue source and Echoing Truth these now. Or I can just hold up mana, so I can block, 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 take three, and then have a backup. That seems better. I guess it's just it would be four damage. Not planning on blocking with the Mold Drifter. So let's just go like this. Yeah. And then if they do something, I can Echoing Truth these or counter. I assume that they'll try to vines this if they do anything. Decided to do nothing. Just untaps the Nettle Sentinel and passes, so I now have pretty much full control. Get to draw four, two more cards, plus another card for turn. I wonder if they'll vines the Mold Drifter here. That wouldn't make so much sense. Okay, so now I get Arcanemancer plus Snap. Arcanemancer into Ephemerate Snap, that's nice. Here, get back to snap. Just snap one of these. Think I'm just going to hold up everything. I have the Mortuary Mire to get back the Mold Drifter, so I'll just block. Let's see what they do. Think they're thinking about a combat trick. Nope. I think this is probably a good moment for a counterspell. Just to get that. It's a heavy mana cost, and this is a good moment for it. We can get use of it and get it out of the hand, and then we're saving the prohibit. And I can also fetch it. I can go Mortuary Mire for Mold Drifter, Ephemerate for Preordain. think one of the cards in their hand is forest. Another Nest Invader. Go ahead and prohibit. Grab an island. Six. So I guess I probably want to get the prohibit back with the ephemerate. So we'll fetch for an island, and then ephemerate for prohibit. Just playing the blue-white control game at the moment. Mortuary Mire back the Mold Rifter. And then play out the familiar. So now we have all the blockers in the world, two backup spells, and plenty of mana to cast things on our next turn. Not going to counter a creature this turn. All right, so I think they have a forest in hand. They just drew a card for turn. Not sure what they're gonna do. All right, that makes sense. They're pretty much locked out. So now post board. We're just bringing in more bounce spells and cutting this. I think one negate, one revoke. Probably bring in the last breaths if I'm playing the. I guess I don't need the revoke if I have Echoing Truth. Yeah, seems fine. So we're just going to play bounce, kill your stuff, live, attack the Mold Drifters eventually. Four snaps, one Echoing Truth. That seems pretty good. And I'm ready to rock. Playing around Savage Swipe is pretty important in this matchup. All right, here we go. On the draw. I'm glad that I so this is also another very slow hand, so I'm gonna mulligan. This is quite a bit better. I think I'll get rid of the familiar. So here I'm running out the Faithful and directly into a Savage Swipe, which isn't great, but then I can play another one and ponder. This turns off Quarian Ranger into Hitskull, so that's good. If I draw a pond or an island, I can go Faithful Ponder and then just have a ton of life. It'd be kind of a block to them. Here they would have to Vines my creature, which they're not going to. Since I'm trying to find lands, I'm going to ponder, I think. Just to see if I have it coming up. And then shuffle. All right. So this is a Savage Swipe moment if they have it. They could do the whole Savage Swipe into Hunger again. There's a swipe. Quarian Ranger. Just hit for five, and that's it. Okay. So we didn't draw a land. It's a bit unfortunate, but I still have the blocker and the life gain. Looking for a land here. Bottom, bottom. Okay, last breath. So, plan is to not block and then force action on their turn. They drew a land. I think I'm not winning this game if I block and they vines. So now I can try to force something to happen. Here I'm gonna block. They're not doing anything. So I'll last breath this. So if they vines, I'm probably going to ephemerate. They're going to elephant guide. Try to last breath it. Get the last card out of their hand. Okay, they vines there. That is going to be 8 damage, but we can snap it. And then they're gonna need a something really good to get out of this. I think tapping out is useful here, so we still need to get the land, and then on the next turn. I think I'm just gonna get the land and then ephemerate and hold a prohibit on the next turn. So right now, if they have exactly vines, then I have to block here, so I'll just block. Gonna cast Hunger. Okay. So they have just Quirion in hand. I got Preordain. Looking for a land again. Drop this. Arcanemancer, get back, snap. Let's see what they do. They're gonna play a spell. Rancor? Okay. Well, that wins the game for me, I think. So I get to go to one. That's nice. Snap this. Now I can ephemerate snap, or I can and just prohibit. I guess my plan is going to be to just block the Quirion Ranger with the Godfrost Faithful if they Rancor it up. That way I'm not walking into anything. Pit Skulk. Okay. We could probably Rancor this. I can just Ephemerate. And then snap it. So now they lose their Rancor. And then I guess I don't really need to counter it because I have enough blockers. think I'm probably just gonna Ephemerate for a cantrip. I suppose they could draw Elephant Guide, which would be a problem. Okay, I have Snap. I want the island, but I'm going to just take the cantrip as well. Okay. Well, Drifter's a good pickup. Then I can Drifter Ephemerate and hold up Prohibit. I guess Prohibit and Snap. Yeah, we gonna win this one. That feels good. Starting off pretty well. It's interesting, just being able to win versus Stompy without ever having any like Stonehorns or anything. It's just interaction's good enough. Alright, this seems like they want to play Hunger. So I'm gonna block, kill the creature, and then snap. And again, I don't have to counter this because I can just block it. This allows me to play it Drifter Ephemerate and then hold up Prohibit still. Right now I have a Echoing Truth. Okay, we have all kinds of things. Just chill. Right, we got it. And that feels good. We're 1-0, and we'll see you in round 2.